Keep On Running was a very big surprise to us when it made number one, because it was, a matter of fact, the record that was never meant to be an A-side. It was supposed to be the B-side of a record. The A-side, which we liked very much, was turned down by the record company. And we had, in fact, recorded Keep On Running in a completely different manner from the way it finally went out on disc. And we had girl singers on it, piano, it sounded ever so sweet. And we rearranged it completely and put the fuzz box in and used that heavy bass figure in the beginning. There's no conflict between my academic background and the kind of music I play, because even while I was at university, I was always interested in jazz. Can be described as being basic, earthy. It's the sort of the raw, belting rhythm and blues. Steve's performance on stage is something that being with him for two years, I find it's very hard to understand how anybody can be so good. I think our group relies more than a great deal on his talents. Both Steve and Muff had classical training in the Birmingham and Midland Institute. Steve, I think he's been playing piano since he was about 8 or 9, possibly even earlier. Even now and again, when we arrive at a job, he plays us a little bit of Bach. Well, I don't think we're going to keep making number one hits, but if we stop making hit records anyway, I think that those of us who want to stay in the music business, actually playing, will do so. Obviously, Steve Winwood will probably do this. He'll probably form his own band. I've got vague ideas of getting a tenor sax myself. You know, I think that you can get a fantastic sound out of them. I've got a clarinet, which I love to play Burgundy Street Blues on very badly. I was born in Swansea in South Wales, and my parents still live there. My father at the moment is a GPO engineer, and things are a little better. Mum's just an ordinary housewife. And my brother is a deckhand on a tugboat in Swansea Docks. It was a sacrifice for my parents to keep me on in school, and then to go on to university, I did get a grant, so it wasn't so bad. But the thing was to keep somebody who's sort of 18 and 19 in the house when normally people leave school at 16 is a bit much, you know. Funny enough, my parents weren't disappointed when I suddenly broke into the pop world. They knew I was always interested in music. They bought me a piano accordion when I was about 13 or 14. I remember going caroling with this thing. I bought a new house. Well, it's not a new house, actually. It's built in 1939. I bought this house in Potter's Bar. I've been married for 3 years. 3 years last month, as a matter of fact. And got a baby daughter, Sarah, who's more than a handful. You know, she's a real rip snorter. She's into everything. I don't think being a family man has affected my popularity or our popularity in any way, because I think fans have got over the stage of having sort of idols who mustn't marry. I've been in the house for about 5 weeks, and I think I've probably been home about 8 times. My daughter, her favorite saying is, when I come in, she says, "Ooh, there's Daddy, goodbye." The pop business and the people in it is a very interesting world. You know, we've suddenly found it, so anyway, I think we really have been spoiled by the people in the business itself. You know, if I may say so, we've sort of become their darlings. I don't know why. Secretly, you know, I have a confession to make. People say I'm not affected by the paraphernalia that goes on with pop singers screaming at you and all the rest of it, but I think I do like it, really.
Well, back now is